I had wings like Noah's dove.
Oscar Isaac does a lot of things very well. In addition to being a talented singer and musician, he is steadily becoming one of the most intriguing actors in Hollywood. As an actor, Isaac's breakout role came in 2006, playing Joseph in The Nativity Story. Over the next few years, Isaac acted in a variety of films. Everything from historical dramas to romantic comedies, giant epics to gritty art house. Despite Isaac never being the lead actor, he proved himself to be quite the scene stealer. Whether it be his striking appearance, his unsettling intensity, or even his musical abilities.
There was no writing on the walls, no warning signs to follow.
Oscar Isaac commanded attention. Then in 2013, Isaac landed his first leading role in the Coen Brothers' Inside Llewyn Davis.
Hang me, oh hang me, I'll be dead and gone.
I don't say this lightly when I say that Inside Llewyn Davis is one of my favorite films of all time. I find it to be a stone-cold masterpiece, and this is largely due to Isaac's marvelous performance as Llewyn Davis. The Coens seem to fully realize Isaac's potential and expertly honed in on his skill set. It goes without saying that Llewyn needed to be a talented musician, which Isaac is.
I shall lose the branch too. I shall lose the branch too.
But Llewyn also needed to be the perfect balance of likable and offensive. Charming and foul.
You get to play it if and only if you sing.
Right, yeah, okay. I can tell this is one of those things where I keep saying no and you think I'm just asking you to beg more.
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, well, look, I'm not a trained poodle.
I thought singing was a joyous expression of the soul.
The kind of guy that makes you simultaneously want to laugh and scream at him.
Where do you live, Al?
Downing Street.
Yeah, nice place.
It's a dump.
Uh-huh. Got a couch?
The music is phenomenal. But Isaac's ability to nail the Coen's signature brand of sardonic humor is really what elevates the film to a new level.
And I can't get this money back?
This was money you owed your union. You Hugh Davis's kid?
Yeah. How's he doing?
He's f***ing great. Matter of fact, he's been asking after you.
This was echoed a few years later when Isaac took on a much less acclaimed film directed by George Clooney, but written by the Coens.
If anything happens to me, you're in deep, deep, deep.
Inside Llewyn Davis seemed to be a sort of artistic awakening for Isaac. Not only did he carry Llewyn's dry wit into a variety of his later roles,
so who talks first? You talk first? I talk first.
He also broke out of the seemingly restrictive roles of his early days and took on parts that allowed him to thrive. Characters that are complex and layered and flawed. While most of Isaac's praise is aimed at his performances in smaller films, you can't overlook his work in blockbusters. Over the course of 2 years, Isaac starred in 3 films that earned a combined total of nearly $4 billion. Despite this tremendous success and the guaranteed fame that comes along with a property like Star Wars, Isaac continued to take on smaller artistic fare where he really shines. With the looks for rom-coms, the talent for drama, the star power for blockbusters, in addition to his musical prowess, I think it's safe to say we will be seeing a lot of Oscar Isaac in a lot of different things for many years to come.
Oh, farewell. Oh, honey. Farewell.